Hello, and thank you for watching The Righteous Kitchen, a cooking and baking blog found at www.therighteouskitchen.blogspot.com. Today I am making beef tri-tip roast, and I'm going to put it on the rotisserie. Therefore, I am working on the drip tray pan and keeping my cutting board clean. Now, the beef tri-tip isn't available across the United States. It's regional. This cut of meat is from Santa Maria, California. It's a tri-tip. That means there's three tips to this roast that are points of other roast cuts. So it's a special cut of roast called tri-tip. They have a pork tri-tip and a beef tri-tip. Today we're making the beef, and what I do is I keep it really simple. If you're going to make a Santa Maria style, they have Pappy's seasoning, which a lot of people use. I personally like my own seasoning. It starts with equal parts of righteous seasoning, garlic powder, and pepper. All I'm gonna do is coat the tri-tip in cooking oil, and I'm gonna liberally season with all of these seasonings. On both sides. So just get in here, and the oil will help the seasonings to stick. And just flip the other side. This is an untrimmed roast, meaning that there's a layer of fat on it. I keep the fat because that'll melt down as we're cooking it. And you can cook these several ways. You can grill it and then put the lid on and cook it over the grill. Or you can bake it in a 350 degree oven. Or my favorite, like I said, is to put it on the rotisserie. They're all gonna cook about the same amount of cooking time. And you know, you really can't mess up a tri-tip. The only thing I would say that would mess it up is if you cut too much of this fat layer off of it. You're gonna have a dry roast. So keep the fat on there. But I am gonna trim it in just a second. But on this, you're gonna season it really heavily because this fat is gonna be melted down. And then when you slice it, you know, you don't eat the layer of fat. So keep as much fat as you can. And let me grab a knife real quick and I'll do a little bit of trimming on this. Okay, what I'm gonna do is just get any pieces of fat that are just scraggly, like this mainly. And then these little I'm just trimming it. I'm not going in here and removing a hunk of fat. See, we have these pieces like this. Now, people always ask what size of a tri-tip. All these tri-tips come packaged at about 3 pounds. Three and a half pounds. They're not very big. So that's what they're all, you're just going to get a package. They're all going to be similar sized. They'll be either trimmed or untrimmed. And if you see one that's trimmed where there's no fat on it, that's not going to be a good roast. That'll be good if you want to cube it or do something else with it. But as far as a roast goes, keep the fat cap on it. All right, so what I'm going to do is let this sit. I'll probably, let me go ahead and put this skewer on it and I'll have it ready. This is the first time I'm using this rotisserie, and it's a really nice vintage Town and Country. All right, what I'm doing is just getting a hole on each end. And that's going to help me to put this rotisserie, this rod through there. You want to make sure that we're going through the center. I'm going to have to stand this up. I got it through both ends. All right, so I have one end on here. Now I'll put the other end through. Okay, so it's on here. So this two pieces of the skewer, I'm gonna adjust this, maybe put it towards the middle. So this rotisserie would easily handle two tri-tips on here. And I'm putting it where these two come together. I want to make sure that most of the meat is there to keep it stabilized. All right, so this is ready. And I'm gonna let it refrigerate for about an hour to get this season the meat here. Let it, you know, get some flavor build up here. Okay, this is the rotisserie Town and Country All Electric Barbecue Rotisserie. It's from the 50s, I believe. And it's a very nice, let's see, it's a very nice unit. It came with this cart with a cutting board and two trays, Formica trays. It's on wheels. It has a really nice glass door so you can see what's cooking. And the glass keeps everything nice and clean, keeps all the splatters inside. Nice stainless steel rotisserie. Easy on and off switch. Roast it or keep it warm, so that's a nice option too. So I have everything ready. So I'm going to go ahead and get the roast and bring it on out and put it on the rotisserie. Okay, I've already put the rod into the rotisserie. It has one end that notches in, and then the other goes into a notch. The two pieces of the rotisserie rod are clamped together. The drip tray is in place. So I'm going to go ahead and close these windows. That's going to keep everything nice and clean and keep flies from getting in there. And I'm just going to go ahead. I'll be right back and I'll flip the switch on this. All right, we're just going to put this on roast. Put it in the middle and flip it on. Put it, make sure it's on the roast part instead of the broil. So it's on roast, and there it goes. It's about 10 minutes after 9, and we'll see how long this takes. It shouldn't take more than an hour and 45 minutes for this tri-tip to finish cooking on the rotisserie. I have set up a little ring camera so I can keep an eye on this rotisserie. It's only been a few minutes and everything looks like it's going well. So, but this is a nice little trick if you want to keep an eye on something but be in the house and the air conditioning. Just set up your ring camera and you could watch it at any moment. This beef tri-tip has been cooking for 1 hour and 20 minutes. I'm going to go ahead and take it off of the rotisserie. I had this on the rotisserie for 1 hour and 20 minutes, and it is coming up to temp about 160, and that would be medium done. You can cook this longer if you want, but medium to done. You don't really want it overdone. You want it to stay nice and tender. So it's just at a little over 160. It's about 162. This was quicker than the oven. Usually takes 1 hour and 45 minutes. I have a smaller Farberware tabletop rotisserie, an open hearth rotisserie. That takes an hour and 45 minutes as well. Since this was a bigger commercial rotisserie, it took less time at about a 1 hour and 20 minutes. So what I do when I bring it in, this spit here, this rod is very hot. I use my oven gloves to remove it from the rotisserie. And then I have a cool pan. I'm gonna let this sit for at least 5 minutes before I slice it and before I take this rod out of the center. I want all of the juices to hold inside the meat. So I'm going to let this 5 to 10 minutes, just let it sit and hang out before you slice it. All right, I have let this cool. The rotisserie spit isn't hot anymore. So that's, everything's cooled down. And I'm just gonna go ahead and release this. This has got a nice crust on it where that fat was. It's a little bit crunchy. All of the fat cap has melted off. I'm going to go ahead and put this on here. You want to cut it across the grain. So if you look at this, the grain is running that way. So you're going to cross, do it opposite. So I'm gonna let you get this stabilized. And you can see how tender that is. Okay, so the cut is going this way. So I wanna go opposite of that. That's how you keep your roast tender. You can slice it as thin or as thick as you want. If you're using this for sandwiches, you're gonna want them, you know, pretty thin. What I do is just kind of keep it in the shape of the roast. Now, as you get to this larger end, it's going to go from well done, and it's going to get well done, medium, and then a little bit just done, a little bit of pink on there. So there we have it, one full tri-tip beef roast. Look at that, it's nice and juicy. It's nice and tender. The ends are more done. And then towards this thicker, it's got a little bit of pink in it. So you've got, you know, it depends on what kind of cut do you want. Do you want it more done? Grab the ends. If you want a little bit of pink, grab that thicker, bigger piece there. But let's look at this. Nice and juicy, very tender. My husband wanted a sandwich, so he's gonna put this on a hoagie with some provolone cheese melted and a little bit of blue plate mayo. So this is also good as a, you know, tri-tip dinner with some rice pilaf and some steamed vegetables. And I will post some pictures of some plate ideas at the end of this video. But there it is, a perfectly, really simple, easy to make. You really can't go wrong with this beef tri-tip. That very good. Easy cut of meat to work with. Like I said before, just make sure that you keep that fat cap on there. It does melt away, so you know there's a little bit there. You just cut that off before you eat it. But most of it just melts right away and flavors the tri-tip as you're cooking it. Okay, I'm gonna get my husband a sandwich, the meat prepped. So I'm gonna sop up all of these juices here. That's a lot of flavor. And then I'm putting some away in a bag. So before you, you know, clean your board, you wanna get all this juice and gather up all that on the meat. It's a ton of flavor. And if you're putting this on hoagie bread, it's gonna soften up that bread really good. So just get in here and just clean your board with these juices. And then for a sandwich, you kind of want the thinner pieces. They're easier to chew. And then go, you know, get them sopped up, and then you're going to want to just pull that fat off. You don't even have to cut it, just pull it off. comes right off. If you had a slicer, a meat slicer, it'd be perfect for this. You could slice it, you know, as thin as you want. All right, so my hands are all messy here. I'm just gonna stack it and cut it a little bit more. Okay, again, we're getting all the juices off of here. Let me go get his hoagie and then his cheese and mayo, and I'll be right back. Okay, I have a bolillo bun. I'm going to cut it in half. Some blue plate mayo, both sides. Then you just want to load this up with the tri-tip. All the way to the ends. Then you're going to put the cheese. And put it under the broiler until the cheese melts. All right, this is hot and melty. Very hot. So I'm gonna just get this on the board. There it is. Tri-tip sandwich. Nice and juicy. All right, I'll have my husband come in a minute and he could taste that and see, you know, how that meat turned out. Okay, so we're gonna get the hubby's review on this tri-tip sandwich made just the way he liked it, with blue plate mayo and melted provolone cheese. So let's see how we did here.
Awesome.
Is that meat? Now you're dripping, the juices are dripping out of that meat. It's so nice and tender. How's the meat taste?
Awesome.
Is it seasoned enough?
Mm-hmm.
Is it salty?
Mm-hmm.
Well, there wasn't very much salt in it. Is it overly salty?
No.
Look at that. He's going to town on this. Okay, well, there you have it. Tri-tip. It's very easy to make. It's delicious, tender, flavorful. You really can't mess it up. I just walked you through it. So you could have it as a sandwich or as a slicing roast for a nice dinner. All right, thanks for watching.